The main purpose of our Center for Biomedical and Minority Health Research is to address the existing disparities and inequities in healthcare, especially among our underrepresented minority populations here in the United States, and more specifically for us in Harris County and Greater Houston area. We have several research areas here, and my lab mainly focuses on maternal health and child health research in terms of epidemiology work, looking again to close those gaps in health disparities here in our Greater Houston area and Harris County. The other type of research that I do is drug discovery and development research, where we look for new medicines for specific infectious diseases. For example, with the outbreak of the recent COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2 that led to the COVID-19 pandemic, our lab is looking at repurposing some clinically approved drugs to work with the FDA to push some of those to be repurposed for the treatment of COVID-19.
My research is rooted in Texas Southern University and the community around it. So with that, I focus a disease such as cancer, infectious disease, diabetes, etc., and most of them disproportionately impact the minority. And for example, prostate cancer and breast cancer are the two major focus of my research. And they have obvious disparity for African Americans, men or women. So with that, with our nano-formulated drugs, we're trying to reduce the disparity and improve the patient compliance. Recently, our work have been recognized as a National Cancer Institute, which is part of NIH. We become one of their subcontractors for preclinical drug development. There are total 19 institutes get that subcontract, and we're the only one from Texas, and we're the only one, the only HBCU get that contract. So I consider that's a great recognition of our work.
Our research is very unique, and we are in the area of gapping the drug discovery toward actual marketing of a drug product. So our facility is very unique, at least in the Texas Medical Center area here, as well as in the state of Texas. That's why we have the separate funding to support our center to provide this type of service. And we have gained a lot of experience as well as a lot of collaborations with investigators across the Texas Medical Center and the state of Texas.
When it comes to disparities in maternal mortality, our country nationally, the United States, is doing really poorly compared to other developed countries. So the work we do is very key in addressing the underlying causes and looking at the root causes of those disparities and poor maternal health outcomes. And so that's what our lab does. We work with a huge center. We just received a huge funding from Health Research Services and Administration to address and improve maternal health in the Harris County and Greater Houston area.
One of the ways that we've seen kind of real world engagement and impact is through a collaborative that has been born out of the Community Engagement Corps in a partnership with the Gulf Coast Consortia to develop a community engaged healthcare educational program. So it's really been exciting to provide this educational opportunity where the community is educating our clinicians and our researchers in how to do this better, in how to develop and deploy, make available important life-saving interventions and technologies.
For me, it's all about watching the light bulb turn on, the fire get lit again or rekindled in our participants' eyes. And that's been the huge payoff for me, to see faculty come into being, become more excellent at what they're doing, to see the energy come back again, and it spills out into their students. They're happier people. It was just very rewarding.
CPRIT stands for Cancer Prevention Research Institute of Texas. And within the name itself, it is cancer prevention. So we applied for this funding mechanism under the prevention pillar of CPRIT, which positions us or allows us to be able to offer mammogram at no cost to uninsured and underinsured women. So with that, we are addressing a major barrier for that population. The fact that we're able to provide services that is a bit more convenient, you know, accessible and specifically at no cost to uninsured, underinsured women is a big it's a big priority for CPRIT, and we are very grateful to have been able to receive that.
One of the great things that are coming next in the future and that we're working on, because we like to think ahead and work ahead, is that the university has deployed a lot of infrastructure for artificial intelligence. When it comes to artificial intelligence, the marriage between artificial intelligence and social determinants of health. So our core facilities here at Texas Southern University, we've deployed a lot of infrastructure, resources, and capacity into studying the role of artificial intelligence in addressing a lot of these disparities within maternal health, and even using artificial intelligence for drug discovery and development. We hope that in the future, with all our work, we hope to see that the synergy of working together with the key stakeholders will really move the needle when it comes to reducing breast cancer health disparities within our community that we serve.